Hello, so today is the second IT lesson for Microsoft Word. So I will just continue off from where we left off last week. Okay, 所以今天就是第二个电脑课做 Microsoft Word. So we learned quite a couple of things last week, like changing font style, font size, and a bit of like the formatting of the fonts, the letters here. So today I will continue on with some more things to add about editing your text, and then also I'll talk about paragraphing. Okay, so to start off, so last week we learned how to change the color of the font and the words, right? So today I'm going to teach you all how to highlight your words. So example, if you have a big chunk of information and you want to point up something that is more important, so maybe let's say I type up a few things that, so maybe there is big chunk of information to read and I want to highlight certain points. Okay, so maybe there is something that you want to point out in this sentence. So how do you want to highlight this? So one way, some people will, maybe they will bold it. You can bold it, like what I taught you last week, or underline, but or like change color is one way to do it. But some people like to highlight. So if you like to highlight, then you see this, you see my cursor. This is to change font color, right? So next to it is to highlight your words. So if I click onto this box with the yellow thing, it will automatically just highlight it yellow. But if you want to change the highlighting color to something different, then you click on this drop down arrow here, and then you can change the colors here. There's green, there's also like light blue. Oh, and another thing is that this one is quite interesting. So if let's say you never highlight, like you never drag the letters that you want to highlight before, and you decide that immediately you just want to click on this, you can actually, it will actually act like an actual highlighter. So you just drag your cursor to the words that you want to highlight, and then it will actually change it. And then if you do it again, then it will unhighlight it. So if I want to unhighlight, remove the highlight for this part, I just drag it over again. So how you know that this function is on is that if you see my cursor, can you see that there is this like pen slash thing on the cursor? Without it, it looks like this, right? But when I click on this, then it has this. So that means that the highlighter function is on. Then you can just highlight things. Okay, 所以现在我做的就是好像一个荧光笔一样，所以如果你要把一些字好像放比较明显一点， then 你可以用这个荧光笔的function. 所以你如果你要用， then 你可以按好像 okay, let me undo. Okay, so 如果你要 把这两个字放比较明显一点， then 你可以找这个荧光笔的按钮， then 你按这个很小的那个地方， then 你按下来， then 你可以看很多不同的颜色， then 你可以选黄色、青色还是蓝色还是粉红色， 什么也可以啦。 then 如果你 okay, 所以如果你 没有把你要换的字把它drag 出来， then 你可以直接按这个， then 你看你的那个 cursor 会有好像一个笔的那个图案，就是讲你可以就是那个荧光笔的 function 就开住了啦。所以如果你要把这个字 information 把它弄黄色，那你可以直接这样。 把它拉这样啊，then, 那整个字会变黄色咯。Okay, so this is quite straightforward lah. If you already understand how the changing of the letter, the if you really understand how the font colors work, then you will understand how to highlight easier. Okay, so this is one thing, and another thing I wanna add on is maybe you type a lot of things, and then there's some things that you want to delete, but you're not very sure whether you wanna delete it yet. So one thing that I like to do is strike through. So to basically have a whole like cancel, you cancel the sentence you wanna write, but it'll still be there. So you see, it looks like this, or like this. So this is when you strike through the whole thing. So how do you do it? So you saw where I went just now, right? So you have to highlight the text you want to cancel first. Then you find this portion here. So it's beside the underline here, strike through. You just click it, and then you'll strike through whatever you highlighted. So this one is not say everyone will use one lah. It's if you feel like it works better for you when you are doing things, then this is something you can consider. But some people think it's a bit messy, so they don't like to use it. But for me, I like to use it if like I have a whole big paragraph I want to delete, but I don't know whether I actually want to delete it yet. Then I will use the strike through function to just keep it there first, but to tell myself that it is not included in the actual text. Yeah. 所以现在我讲的就是，如果你要把东西好像挂掉，可是你不要把它删除掉先，那你可以用这个 strike through function， 就是它会把一个横线写放在你的字的上面，所以你先就是要一样 select 那个你要挂掉的字 ，then 你就按这个按钮，就是在那个 underline 的旁边把它按一次 ，then。你的字就会被刮掉了啊、，so this is quite easy lah. Then that's it for the text part. So the next part I'm gonna do is on paragraphing. So this is for when you have a lot of words or basically just like a paragraph of information and it's like continuous and you want to organize it better or there's some way you want to edit it.So, I didn't prepare a paragraph, but let's just copy and paste this. Okay, so now it looks like a paragraph. Let's just pretend this is a paragraph, okay? And this is what you are working with. So, you see, initially, Microsoft Word already sometimes may give you some formatting initially. So, just now you see the words were quite spaced apart because Microsoft Word registers that as like a new paragraph. But let's say if I have just one whole paragraph of things, and maybe you want to give it to someone to read. For me, right, if I look at this and I try and read it, it's gonna be very hard to read. So it's even worse if like I have more than one paragraph. Okay, let's say I have this whole thing.Then you look at it, then you're like, oh my god, that's so spaced, like so close together, it gets a bit messy. And especially if the font size is even smaller, right? Like some people like to use smaller font size, or maybe their assignment requires a smaller font size, then maybe like they put font size 10, wow, it's very hard to read lor. So what is some things you can do? So in terms of paragraphing, you edit your paragraph here.Okay, this, you see this thing that I'm circling around? This is where you edit your paragraph. So, first thing I'll show you is paragraph alignment. So right now, the paragraph is aligned to the left. So that means, what that means is that every new sentence, every word that you type, you'll start from the left to the right. So it's like normal reading, how we read things from left to right. Okay, so you can see it here.This is where you edit your paragraph alignment. So you see this is grayed out, right? It means that it is aligned to the left. So let's say you want to align it to the right. Maybe for some reason you want to align it to the right. Then you click on this one. So this one is left. You can see the words start from the left to the right, like the lines. So this one, the lines start from right to left. So you just click on it once. Then everything starts from the right to the left. So your sentences still start from the left, but you see they are all like they are shifted towards the right now. So I don't usually use this. I only use this if like I'm like doing pictures and all that, and then I put captions or something. Otherwise I don't really align things to the right. It's a bit weird lah. Yeah. Then another one is to align to the center. So center is the one in the middle of the both of them. So this one. So your text will be in the center. So in terms of aligning to the center, people usually use it more for like titles. So if we use the title thing that I talked last week, so this title, if this is the title for everything, I can just align it to the center. Then that's the title, and then after that, there's everything going on at the bottom. Okay, so this is for alignment. And another one is justified. So this one is to make it look sort of neater in a sense. So you see this, I already chose a justified function. So justified is this one, the one with all the equal lines here. So justified basically means that the words are more like evenly spaced apart, and they end sort of like, they look like one big rectangle. Like you can see it's like one big rectangle. Yeah. So if you want to compare justified and left alignment, so okay, let me just, okay. So this is justified. This paragraph is justified. And this paragraph is aligned to the left. So the difference is not very big, I would say, but personally I think that justified looks neater. If you're just typing things for yourself and you think that this one is better for you, then this is the justified function. But if you think this one is better for you, then this is the left alignment function. It's just that justified, the spaces are more equal compared to this one. Okay, so that's for the paragraph alignment. Okay, 所以 刚才我讲就是那个你 如果你有很多字, then 你放很多片段, then 刚才第一个我讲的就是 那个字是 align to the left, 就是 左边。所以左边 如果你的片段是从 那个 alignment 是左边, then 你就是按这个 按钮。 所以 通常人们是用 这个 function, then 如果你要放成右边, then 你就按这个。 通常人们不会用 右边的啦, 我自己会用右边，只是说如果我要做 放图片, then 我要放一个很小的字在下面, then 可能我会用那个右边的。 Then 另外一个就是 中间, 这个是用来做你的好像你的 title, 你的题目。 所以如果你 刚才我是放在这边的对吗, then 如果我要把那个题目放在中间我就按这个, then 它就会在中间, 就 then 这个就是你的题目了, then 下面就是你的字。 OK, 所以 最后一个就是那个 justified 是很像那个右边 左边的可是会看起来比较 比较我觉得比较好看啦。 我不知道如果你们喜欢这个 justified, 可是我觉得是比较整齐的。 Then 如果你要看那个差别, okay, 所以 上面的这个片段是 justified, 下面的是用右边 左边的 alignment. 所以你看哪一个比较适合你, then 你就可以用哪一个咯。 Yeah, so that's for alignment of the paragraphs. And the next thing I want to talk about is line spacing. So just now I said that this is very hard to read, right? The reason why I say this is very hard to read, for me, I think the words are too close together in terms of like the line. So what do I mean by lines? This is one line. This is one line. So lines, like, yeah. So how to make it more spaced apart? So first you need to highlight the paragraph you want to change. Then you click on this. So just now the paragraphs are here, right? This is where you change the line spacing. So if you hover your cursor over the thing, you can see that it says line and paragraph spacing. So you just click on it. And there are some preset numbers here. So you can see that, you can already see the paragraph changing as I move down the numbers. I'm not even clicking on it yet. I'm just like moving up and down. So you can see that the lines are getting further apart. So for me, I'll use either 1.15 or 1.5. So obviously the bigger the number, the bigger the spacing is between the lines. Yeah, but of course if you make a spacing that is too wide, like 3.0, it looks a bit weird lah. So you just have to pick the line spacing that is suitable for whatever you're doing. So if you're doing this for your own reading or whatever, you can pick whatever that suits you better. But for me, I like to use the 1.5. Then something extra. So when I used, last time when I was younger, when I used this Microsoft Word, I also didn't know a lot of like the functions. And sometimes, I always wonder why is there an extra spacing in between paragraphs like this. And sometimes, maybe you want to remove it. So how to remove is, you highlight the paragraph that you want it to be changed. Then you go to the same line spacing thing. Then you see these two things here. Add space before paragraph or remove space after paragraph. So this one will affect the spacing before the paragraph, which is the in between important things and this paragraph. So if I add a spacing, then you can see it gets further apart. But if I remove the spacing, then it goes back to just now. Then Microsoft Word, for mine, they like to automatically put spacing after paragraphs. So if I want to remove that spacing, then I press the remove. So now the words are closer together. But if you have a lot of paragraphs, then I would recommend you to add the spacing because it allows the reader to read it more easier. And if you are the one reading it also, then it's easier for you to read. Okay? So that's just something extra lah. I didn't add it in the slides or instructions or whatever, so it's just like for your own general knowledge. Okay. 所以现在我讲的就是, 你看我的字有很多很多, 但刚才, 我有讲, 你看你要读, 这个片段很难读, 为什么呢? 是因为那个字, 那个一行一行很, 很近, 那个字很近的时候就会比较难读, 所以, 如果你要换那个, 那个, 近还是远, then 你就可以用, 这个 line spacing option. 所以如果你找不到那个 line spacing, 你就可以就是在这边的旁边, then 他会讲 line and paragraph spacing, 就是 会换那个距离. 所以你看我 按的时候, then 我用我的 cursor 就动 上面和下面, 你就可以看到那个片段已经在换那个 一行一行的距离了. 所以我喜欢用的就是 1.15 还是 1.5, 因为这两个就是最容易读的. Then 如果你用比较大的字, then 那个 一行一行的距离会比较远. 所以你看哪一个比较适合你要 写的东西啦, 有些人也是用 2.5, 可是通常是用这三个选择啦, 可是我自己觉得 1.0 会太紧, 所以我喜欢用 1.15 或者是 1.5. Then, yeah, so that's for the line spacings. And the very last thing I want to talk about is bullet and number points. So bullet and number points is when, maybe example, you're not writing a lot of paragraphs, you want to list out things. So maybe I have a list of things. And I want to list out maybe, I don't know, like food. So maybe milk, juice, butter, sugar. Okay, so now I have a list of things. And I want to, you know, sometimes when you write lists in on paper, then you have to put like some bullet points, like some dash or some numbering. So you can actually do this on Microsoft Word also. So what you have to do is, first thing, you have to highlight the things you want to make into a list. Then you find this paragraph box again. Then you find above this paragraph alignment thing, this circles, this very small blue circles. This is bullets. So if you click on it once, this box, right, just this box, it will automatically give you circular bullets. So now you see, it has been converted into like a list lah. But if you want to change like the style of the bullets, you can click on the arrow next to it, and there's these different options of bullets. Yeah, so there's also a lot more here, but I won't go into it. Like, if you want, you can go and explore yourself. There's like different other different functions and other ways you can add like new bullets. But basic, for your basic like knowledge, this is actually good enough already. I also don't even go and like look at all these. I only use this one, or this one most of the time. Yeah. Then if maybe you don't want bullets, you want it to be numbered. You want to know how many things are in your list. Then you can click on the one next to it. You see this number, it's very small lah, but you can see 1, 2, 3. You click on this one, and then it will automatically change into numbers. So now you know there's 4 things in your list. If you want to change the same thing, maybe you don't want numbers, you want letters or you want something else, then you can click on the arrow next to the numbers. Then you can see there's different ways also. Just now it's 1, then got the dot. Then this one is 1, then use the bracket. Then there's also Roman numerals. The I, then I, whatever. Then also got the B, ABC in like dots and also the bracket one lah. So, same thing. There's also other ways you can add your bullet points. You can go and explore if you want. I personally have never explored these extra functions. I only use either the 1, 2, 3 or the ABC. So, yeah. And then if you want to remove, you just click none lor. Then you'll go back to usual. Okay, so that's for bullet points. Okay, 所以如果你要做好像一个单，你要写一些东西，好像你要买东西，还是你要你写东西的时候，你要看你有几个东西还是什么，你可以用这个 bullet point 的 option. 所以第一个我要讲的是，没有字母，没有号码的，就是讲只有这个圈圈。所以怎样弄那个圈圈的东西，你就找。 在这边的上面 它会讲是 bullets 啦， 所以你就把它按一次， then 你会他们会放那个圆圈。 如果你要换那个圆圈换成别的东西， 你就可以按这个 arrow 下来， then 会有不同的 pattern 啦。 我自己是用这三个而已。 可是如果你要去找别的，还是你要自己去弄别的， then 你可以去自己去研究一下啦，因为我自己也是没有用这些的。Yeah，then 如果你要用，你要看你写的有几个东西， then 你就可以用那个 number list number points，所以就是在 bullet point 的旁边， then 你就按，你按一次，它会自然放的是号码。可是如果你要 别的 pattern， 那你可以一样的按那个旁边的 arrow， then 有不同的，好像这个是一点， then 二点， then 三点， then 这个是一， then 有那个 bracket， then 二那个 bracket， then 也是有 ABC， 还有其他的一二三啦，所以你自己看哪个比较适合你。那如果你要把它弄掉，就按难，还是你就按多一次， then 就会。 它就会换掉， okay? So, yeah, so that's about it. I'm not sure if I mentioned this in the previous video, but if you want to undo things, so let's say if like you type something or you accidentally made something, you don't know what happened, why become like, why become like this, then you want to put it back to what happened, what it is before, you go and find, just remember last week I told you all how to save, right? So beside the save button, there's this undo button. So if you click it once, it will undo like whatever action you did before. If you undo again, then it will undo to like my two steps back lah. So every time you press undo, you take one step back. If you want to redo, take the one step forward again, then you click the one next to the undo button. So this one is just some basic ones lah. I think I forgot to mention in the previous video, but yeah. So yeah, that's about it. Same thing, if you are still not sure about anything, you can ask me. And I also have this guide here. Chris will add it into the e-learning portal, I think. So there's also these slides that you can look through yourself if you are unsure. And remember to do your practice. Okay, so the practice will get you more familiar with it, and then after you can go and play with it or whatever and try new things lah. So yeah, so that's about it, and I'll see y'all next time.